Hey guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So this is a new day, and in this day we will be discussing a lot of interesting current affairs. So let's begin this video for May 5th, 2021. But if in case you are a newcomer on our channel, then do subscribe and hit this bell notification. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we provide you with the free quizzes, as well as you can resolve your queries by directly connecting with your mentor. So if you want to connect with us, you have any queries related to the course or to the syllabus, then you can join this group by clicking the link in the description below. Here is the 2022 course. So I will be giving you a brief introduction of this course for the people who are coming for the first time on our channel. So guys, here in this new course, you will get 10 mock tests each for every course, for every subject. For example, you have 10 mock tests for phase one, you have 10 mock tests for ESI, 10 for FM, and 10 for English descriptive. In addition to these mock tests, you will get mock interviews as well, where you can assess yourself and try to score good marks in your interviews. The next point here is the booklet that we will be sending you at your place. And this booklet consists of question bank for phase 1, question bank for phase 2, revision booklet for phase 2, as well as past years from 2010 onwards. Now, if you want to avail this course, then you can avail a 30% discount by using the RBI 30 coupon code. In case you have any further queries related to the course, then do feel free to ask us on this number which is right in front of you. Okay, so here the introduction ends and the video begins. That is the question number one. Which company has developed the world's largest aeroplane designed to transport hypersonic vehicles and facilitate easy access to space? So this is the world's largest aeroplane which has been developed, and it has completed its test flight also. Now, which company has developed it? You have five options: Lockheed Martin, United Technologies, Northrop Grumman, Stratolaunch, and Boeing. Out of these five options, the right answer is option B, that is Stratolaunch. Apart from this, an interesting fact related to this news is that this world's largest aeroplane has its name also. So what is the name of this aeroplane? The name is ROC. R-O-C, ROC. So this is the name of this world's largest aeroplane. Now guys, I have a task for you, and that task is that you have to find out where this Stratolaunch organization is located. Where is the headquarters of this organization? So this is your task to find out. Even the country would do. You don't have to go into the specifics of the location. You can just tell me the country only. Okay. Now we have on our second question, that is, which of the following article allows an unelected minister to become the CM, provided that he or she will have to get elected within six months of assuming office? You will get to know why this question is in news, why this question is here in front of your screens after a little while. But first, I would like to discuss the answer of this question. So out of these five options that you are seeing on your screen, the right answer is option D, that is Article 164, subclause 4. So this article allows an unelected person to become the chief minister of the state, provided that he or she will get re-elected through by polls within the 6 months of assuming the office. Now, what does that mean? If the person is unelected, then how he or she will become the chief minister? The reason lies in the West Bengal elections. So recently, in the West Bengal elections, Mamata Banerjee has lost the election within her own constituency, that is Nandigram. So she has lost her elections in Nandigram, which was her constituency. But still, she is going to take oath today, that is on 5th of May. But how is this possible? This is given in the Article 164, subclause 4 of the Constitution. And remember the time period that has been given to that unelected person to become elected. Again, that is the 6 months tenure of assuming the office. If the person fails to get elected within this time period, then he or she will cease to be a minister. So that is the condition. Now let us discuss the other sub clauses of Article 164 as well. So the Article 164 sub clause 1 declares that the chief minister and other ministers shall be appointed by the governor on the advice of chief minister and the ministers shall hold office during the pleasure of the governor. So basically, this is a very simple sub-clause that is stating that the council of ministers will be chosen on the advice of chief minister and will be appointed by the governor. Article 164, sub-clause 2 declares that the council of ministers shall be collectively responsible for the legislative assembly of the state. This is again very simple. I don't think I need to explain it further. Now we have Article 164, sub-clause 3 that declares that the governor shall administer the oath of office and secrecy to the elected chief minister. So this is very simple. Article 164, sub-clause 4, we have already discussed. I'm again saying this thing, guys, that do pay attention to the tenure, which is the term and condition of this sub-clause. So Mamata Banerjee has to face this condition, has to fulfill this condition, and she has to become elected within the 6 months tenure of assuming the office. Next is Article 164, sub-clause 5, that declares that the salaries and allowances of ministers shall be subject, shall be such as the legislature of the state may determine. So that will be decided by the legislature of the state. So that was all about the Article 164 and the sub-clauses of this article. Now we are moving on to our next question. Guys, this question is very important, and I would say that this is the highlight of today's video. So do listen to me very carefully in this question. How many countries have been put on a priority watch list by USA in its special 301 report? So what is this report? What is this that, what does this mean, that priority watch list? That we will be discussing a little later, but let's first discuss the number of countries that have been put on this priority watch list. So you have 8, 9, 7, 10, 5 in the options. Out of these 5 options, the right answer is option B, that is 9. A total number of 9 countries, including India, have been put on the priority watch list by USA in this list of special 301 report. So here, the very first fact that I would like to tell you is that this report is released by the Office of United States Trade Representative. So that is the organization that releases this special 301 report. Now this report assesses the effectiveness of intellectual property rights being implemented by the United States trading partners. And India is one of the most important trading partners of USA at present. So this report assesses the effectiveness of intellectual property rights. Are they being implemented correctly, or are they being implemented strictly in the country or not? That is the subject of this report. So we have discussed 2 facts till now. I'm going to write it for you guys so that we have pointers in front of us. The first fact is USTR releases this report, and second fact is it assesses the intellectual property rights. The third fact here that you should remember about this report is that this report assesses a total number of 100 countries. So intellectual property rights implementation or protection laws are being judged for a total number of 100 countries, and out of these 100 countries, 23 countries have been put on a watch list by USA for this year. And a total number of 9 countries have been put on a priority watch list. That includes India as well. So this is the list, priority watch list, and the watch list, which includes a total number of 23 countries. And priority watch list, that includes India, China, Russia. So major economies are there in this list. Now, why is India here? China is here because China is often accused of intellectual property rights theft. But why is India here? India is here because India has been accused of negligence towards providing benefits to the creators and innovators, as well as lenient intellectual property rights, because we do not have that much strict intellectual property rights implementation in India, as well as we do not provide enough sufficient bonus or incentives to the innovators and creators. And that is why India is on the priority watch list of USA. So these were the highlighted reasons by the USTR for putting India on this list. But what is going on under the table, that is something that we do not know. Now, second thing of importance that you should remember is that recently India was put on a watch list of currency manipulators as well by India. So this is something that India should remain cautious of. India has been put on a watch list of currency manipulators. India has been put on a watch list of countries of particular concern. So countries of particular concern is the list of countries that do not provide enough religious freedoms to it, freedom to its citizens. And the third list is right in front of you, the list of priority watch list of IPR, that is intellectual property rights. So this is something that is the trend now. Okay, so these were the informations related to this report. Okay, so we are moving on to the next question. Who has been appointed as the acting chairperson of National Human Rights Commission? So you have five options: PC Pant, Gaurav Kumar, Hemant Kumar Nanda, Balram Kumar, Jenny Kilong. Out of these five options, which one is the right answer? The right answer is option A, that is PC Pant. So he has been appointed as the acting chairperson of National Human Rights Commission. Who has assumed the additional charge of chairman and managing director of THDC India Limited? So first of all, this THDC is a power utility, an electricity company. So you have five options again: Pankaj Kumar Singh, Manoj Sinha, Vijay Goyal, Dipankar Datta, Sandeep Madan. Out of these five options, the right answer is option C, Vijay Goyal. Here guys, I have a question for you also. Your question is that this THDC is a subsidiary, is a wholly owned subsidiary of a state-run power utility. And which company am I talking about here is your task. You have to find out that THDC is the subsidiary of which major company. So this is your second question for the day. Next and last question is, which country does cricketer Thisara Perera belong to? So you have again the five countries right in front of you: Sri Lanka, West Indies, Bangladesh, South Africa and Australia. Out of these, the right answer is Sri Lanka. So the cricket lovers would have already guessed this answer, but those who don't like cricket, I have already told the answer. So it is Sri Lanka. And why is he in the news? Because he has announced retirement from international cricket. That's why he was making the headlines and I took up this question. And remember guys, the people who retire from their sports or the sports personalities who are in the news because of being banned by ICC or NADA or WADA. So these are the anti-doping agencies that ban cricketers and sportspersons on the charges of doping. So the people who are in the news because of these reasons are also important, because there are chances that these can also become question for you in your examination. So do not ignore such news whenever you go on the list of important news or sports personalities. So that is the end. I hope that you have enjoyed the video and learned a lot during the video. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, then do give us a thumbs up and share it among your friends. Thank you so much.